transmission started. Are you ready for an upgrade in consciousness? I interrupt your regularly scheduled program with what may be the largest hijacking of a reality that anyone has ever attempted. My name is... Why are you staring? Did I not put on the 3D Earth filter again? Oh, sorry about that. My name is Vic, and I want to share with you something that has been a lifetime in the making. If knowledge is power, then the knowledge of self is the highest power there is, and the best news you will ever hear. But just a little background first. This is the time that has been prophesied for thousands of years in many ancient scriptures. It is true. This is the time of revelation, which is a revealing of truth, and apocalypse, which is just an uncovering. What you are witnessing now is disclosure of the highest kind. Three things cannot be long hidden: the sun, the moon, and the truth. This is the cutting edge of consciousness that we're living in right now. This is why you chose to be here now. There will be a lot of changes, and change is not to be feared as long as it's for the better. I've been on a spiritual journey in search for truth and experience for quite some time, and have had my greatest gains once I've turned my focus inward instead of outward. Now I know why Jesus said, "Neither shall they say, lo here or lo there, for behold, the kingdom of God is within you." This crazy world that we live in just didn't seem right to me. And the deeper that I've been going in, the more awakening and experience I've had as to what is really going on and who I truly was. Then suddenly, one day, I woke up. You know, like the fairy tale, row, row, row your boat, life is but a dream. What if you could wake up from it? I did. I can see the matrix now. Even from a physical standpoint, we are all of the same energy. If you believe in science and that E equals MC squared, you may notice there is only one energy. We are indeed all connected in different manifestations of one thing. Even Einstein said, reality is an illusion, albeit a persistent one. I'm not here to profit off anything or anybody. I'm not charging for any information and I have nothing to sell. This is just a way for me to use my creativity, talent, intellect, passion, and will for service to others. I'm not asking you to believe anything that's outside of yourself or that you can't experience yourself. I'm not telling you how the fruit tastes and asking you to take my word for it. I'm not telling you I'm the only one that has access to the fruit and that you need me to taste it. I'm telling you that the fruit is real, free, and showing you where it is so you can taste it yourself. All of the ills that are going on in the world now can be changed by a raising of our consciousness. We can rise above the turbulence and negativity just as a pilot rises above a storm once they know they have controls to the elevator. That's why this is important and relevant for ourselves, our children, and our planet. Spirituality is the key. There's nothing more fundamental than spirituality, as Anthony DeMayo would say. What is spirituality? Spirituality means waking up. Most people, even though they don't know it, are asleep. They're born asleep, they live asleep, they marry in their sleep, they breed children in their sleep, they die in their sleep without ever waking up. They never understand the loveliness and beauty of this thing that we call human existence. This is the good news. The first step is questioning the possibility of who you truly are. Jesus Christ knew he was God. So wake up and find out eventually who you really are. In all culture, of course, they'll say you're crazy and you're blasphemous, and they'll either put you in jail or in the nut house, which is pretty much the same thing. However, if you wake up in India and tell your friends and relatives, my goodness, I've just discovered that I'm God, they'll laugh and say, oh, congratulations, at last you found out. The fundamental truth is you have divinity within you. There is a creative force, for lack of a better word, let's call it God, love, or all there is. All there is everything, including you. You are part of it. And when you remove all that you think you are it. Even Jesus would say, is it not written in your law? I said you are God's. We are truly one being experiencing itself. When you look in the mirror, you are seeing an image of God. Your scriptures even tell you, you were made in God's image, weren't you? Some may look in the mirror and purely see the physical body and hear the ego say that that is you. But who is listening to the ego? In truth, you are experiencing the presence of an ego. It's like trying to describe to someone what a mango tastes like that has never tasted one. You can read volumes of written works on the taste of a mango, but they don't come close to actually tasting one yourself. In the experience of awakening, you realize that there is more to life. There is another level to reality. It's like you are a radio station and you have the ability to tune into a different station that has more harmonious music and is more in tune to nature and the universe. I've diligently worked on this plan for years, observing the amount of resistance and suppression in the mainstream, and formulated my information as simply and as black and white as possible. It's either true or not. I've structured it to whether there is no middle ground. If it's false, it should be easily disproved. If it's true, the world changes. Don't you think this is worth looking into? It's like me saying to an archaeologist, there's gold beneath you. To prove me wrong, they must dig. It's either there or it isn't. To say there isn't anything without digging is to deny the possibility and choose to remain ignorant. Some people are making this choice, and unfortunately, some of these people have a lot of people following them. The blind leading the blind, as they say. As Marcus Garvey says, never forget that intelligence rules the world and ignorance carries the burden. Therefore, remove yourself as far as possible from ignorance and seek as far as possible to be intelligent. Believe it or not, there are influences that do not want you to know this and take control of the power that you have. If you find your own real goal, they can no longer profit off the gold-covered lead that they've been giving us for years. I'm not the only one going through this shift. There are many others experiencing more of themselves and have realized who they are. Now is the time to come out of the shadows and shine as brightly as you can. I've become a fisher of men of sorts, but I'm fishing with a very large digital net that I'm bringing in now. Jesus was also a fisher of men, and even he said, the things that I do, you can and better. So I'm not just reading about it, I'm taking action. My intent is to remove the hurdles of misinformation and fear, and use my journey to truth as an example to help assist you on yours. This has nothing to do with belief, faith, or religion. God has nothing to do with religion. This has to do with the truth. Nobody owns the truth. You are the truth. So let's test this out. Let's have a discussion. I've laid out my logic and thought process in what I've called the 100 degree challenge. It's my cliff notes to awakening, if you will. What happens to water when it reaches 100 degrees? It changes form. It takes that one extra degree to have a totally different experience. Is this not newsworthy? Is this not more important than the latest celebrity antics or team score? Are those part of the distractions put in place to keep you from knowing the truth? Are those things meant to keep you asleep and mentally enslaved? I'm making myself available to speak on this, not because I know it all, but because I know this conversation will enlighten us all and shed light on the falsehoods that have been perpetrated for years. The enlightenment may not be televised, but we can use the system against it. We can use its momentum against it and transform it from the inside out. P.S. The mainstream media is very predictable and not very creative. They have very few choices when faced with a dilemma such as this. They can choose to not engage and attempt to ridicule me, but they can't ridicule my logic or the many people that are coming into this understanding and having these experiences. They can choose to ignore me, but that only makes it worse for them when this does come to light. That would be like digging their own hole, and hopefully they're smarter than that. In a compassionate way, I'm letting them know that it is better to have a conversation now. I'll make myself available to talk, but the only caveat is that it's done openly so I can show it to the people unedited. If you are about the truth, then what's wrong with that? All my info is here for those that wish to discuss, and you can look on my website for times when we'll have our own discussions regardless of the mainstream interaction, starting on the 27th. Please share this video and participate on the level you can. Sitting on the sidelines and watching people that do not have our best interest at heart control and manipulate us is no longer an option. The only thing necessary for the triumph of evil is for good men to do nothing. The truth is a virus worth spreading. Thank you.